In this video, we are going to talk about the examples of the complementary angles. So now let's talk about our first example. So first example is, this is my example number one. Solve sine 1 degree over cosine 89 degrees. Now, let's look at this question. So as you can see, my question is sine 1 degree over cosine 89 degrees. What I need to do, I need to find the complementary angle for 1 degree. So we all know that 1 degree plus 89 degrees, that is equal to 90 degrees. All right? So this one I can write easily as what? Sine 1 degree I can write as 90 degrees minus 89 degrees, right? Over, this is my numerator, over my denominator is cosine 89 degrees. Now, let me remind you the complementary formula for sine. So if you remember, the formula was sine 90 degrees minus theta is equal to cosine theta. So if I follow that formula, I will write this one as, this is equal to sine 90 minus theta, which is what? Cosine theta. So I will write cosine, and theta is what? 89 degrees over cosine 89 degrees. Now, we all know that numerator and denominator is the same value, so I can cancel it out. And I will get the value as 1. So the value of this expression right here is basically 1. Now, let's talk about another example. So my second example is solve sine 58 degrees minus cosine 32 degrees. Now, I'm going to do the same thing. Now, I'm going to use a complementary formula. So I will write this one as, this is equal to sine 58 degrees. And then cosine, I will write cosine 32 can be written as cosine 90 degrees minus 58 degrees. Because 90 minus 58 is what? 32 degrees. So now I'm going to use another formula. So if you remember, the complementary formula for cosine was cosine 90 degrees minus theta is sine theta. Now let's look at this one. Cosine 90 minus theta. So cosine 90 minus theta is what? Sine theta. So I can write this thing as sine theta. And what is my theta? My theta is 58 degrees. So I can write this one as sine 58 degrees minus, again, cosine 90 minus theta is sine theta, so I will write sine, and my theta is 58 degrees from here. Now, you can see sine 58 minus sine 58 is what? 0, because they are the same term. So, this one is same as this one, so I will get 0. Now, as you can see, the questions that we have based on complementary angles, they are pretty simple. Only thing you need to remember, you need to make sure that the sum of two angles are 90 degrees. So if one angle is given, you need to find another angle that add up to the previous angle to make it 90. So for in this example, as you can see, what do I add to 58 to make it 90? And I got 32. So basically this 32 can be written as 90 minus 58, because 58 and 32 add up to 90. And then what you need to do, you need to see which formula is going to work with that particular question. And this is how we will solve the questions based on complementary angles.